Tears Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, let's introduce our winner for this evening. Our first referee is Mary Benedict from Wellington.
Hello.
And our second referee is Mr. Tim Hulls from Dunedin. Our line judges for this evening held all the way from Tina, South Holland.
Welcome back, everyone, to the 2018 Volleyball Secondary Schools National Boys Final between Western Heights High School from Rotorua and Rangitoto College from the North Shore, North Harbour.
All right, stoked to have you guys back here today. Big game here today. Favourites, and with the list we have for Western Heights High School, we have Hemaya Tuaroa Apete, number 2, Tyler Barrett, number 3, Kobe Hewitt, number 4, Josh Tiplady, number 5, James Wong, number 6, Tyron Gillespie, number 7, Liam Chan, number 8, Bailey Gordon, number 9, Drazel Edwards, number 10, Robert Fiaola, number 11, Jalen Massey, and number 12, brother of Tyron, Cole Gillespie, with coach Paora Morrison and assistant coach David Apete.
And I'll go through the Rangitoto College list. Number 2, Joshua Hudson. Number 5, Tim Kwan. Number 7, Sam Anderson. Number 8, and unfortunately he's not playing today, Ryan Dunn. Number 9, Josh Patterson. Number 10, Sam Dodds. Number 11, Travis Harrod. Number 12, Matthew Ness. Number 13, Matthew Bowell. And number 14, Mitchell Coulthurst. They are coached by Johan Timmer, and assistant coaches Alan Kerr and Sam Bowell, and their manager is Josh Bullen. That's Rangitoto College. I think this is their first year they've ever been into the boys' national final.
That's pretty cool. They made it in juniors.
Yeah.
In juniors, when was that? A couple of years ago?
Yep.
A couple of years ago. I think actually there's a couple of boys in the Rangitoto team versus the Orewa team and versing against each other. And then they had that battle in the semi-final last night where Rangitoto beat Orewa 3-2. Very, very tight game, which brought them to the finals. Western Heights got through slightly more convincingly with a 3-0 against, who were they up against? Western Heights.
Oh, Trident.
Trident High School.
Yeah, Rangitoto College came back from 9-3 down in the fifth set.
Big serving game there. It's got first serve from number 13, Matthew. We've got Matthew.
Ooh. Looks like we've got a heavy crowd favourite for Western Heights.
We do. There's very much a crowd favourite. When they started their hitting warm-up, the crowd went crazy.
I heard there's a bit of a backstory about number... Can't see a shirt right now for Western Heights. Number 4. Josh
Tiplady?
Yeah. Apparently he's from Tokyo.
I have heard that. Yeah. That is the goss around the town.
All of his volleyball knowledge before this year was self-taught, watching YouTube clips.
That's actually incredible. That's really awesome. Well done, Josh. I guess Taupo has just in the early days of their establishment of volleyball, so going to Western Heights would have been a good coming into a solid school of volleyball. Yeah. Years they've been going. The Western Heights gym, it's smaller than most, an old gym, but they do all they need in that gym. We've trained in there before, and all of the banners around the room. So shout out to all those at Western Heights High School, those that are back in Rotorua today, watching the game, supporting the boys. Thank you for being awesome for them.
That was number 8 there, Bailey Gordon. Bailey Gordon. Gordon, if you're from Rotorua, the Gordon name is very well known in the volleyball scene. So I think his uncle Mike and father Kurt played in the Western Heights teams through the years. Hi Mike, if you're watching the live stream.
We got some more comments here. Don't need to refresh it. We got 381 people watching at the moment. Welcome. If you want to get a shout out, just put something on the comments and we will give you a shout out today. The crowd must be bigger in this room currently. We've got nearly every single seat filled with people sitting on the chairs around, sitting on the floor around, anywhere they can.
Go Western Heights from Rō Peta.
Serve from number 5, Tim Kwon. Tim Kwon.
Good swing there by number 8, Bailey Gordon.
Brianna Moore, go Heights.
One of the shortest players in the Western Heights team, but he got a very good jump.
In comparison, A standing next to Travis, standing next to Jalen at the front, sorry. Big jump, is that
Sam Kobe. Anderson. Oh.
Kobe Hurtley.
Number 7 from Rangitoto, Sam Anderson's played really well in this tournament. He had a very good game last night.
Go Kobe. Number 3, Kobe Hewitt. Got a few Kobe fans out there. Go Tyron, go Heights. We have a lot of Heights fans on the live stream at the moment. As the any Rangitoto fans out there, let yourselves be known. Heights volleyball, everyone's going. Go Tyron Bogan. Let's go Rangi, there we go. Well done, Adam. The one fan out there, there must be more of you. Thanks for being supportive, Adam. We need them. Big hops there. Right to the corner.
It's a nice good hit from number 11.
Travis.
Travis Harrod. He's up against a very tall block in Himaya and Jalen.
Guess just using the length of the court, longest part. Though looks like it's going out, but he just sneaks into the corner from there. So awesome shot.
Service error.
Miss hit from Sam there on the serve.
5-all.
Go Rangitoto. Woo! Caitlin. Shout out to my main man, number 10, Sammy. You got it. Shout out to Sam Dodds. Playing it opposite there. Weak tips on, but Kobe's got it under control. Tips. Long hit. Looked like it was almost going out there.
Yep.
Huya Khan. Himaya MVP. There's a good throw out there. Number 1, Himaya. Solid hit by Matt there. We're going to have to give them nicknames because we've got Matt Ness and Matt Bell. So we can call one of them Matty and one of them Matthew. So Matty at the front. That's Matty Ness. And number 13 right next to him, Matthew Bell. So we'll just call him Matt.
I wonder if he's related to Sam Bell, if anyone knows Sam Bell. Brothers?
Volleyballer?
Yeah.
Yeah. Let's just assume they're brothers.
Yeah.
Matt and Sam. Good volleyball family.
Nice lead there by number 4, Josh Tibley.
Sam Anderson was actually, I'm pretty sure, one of the boys in the final. Remember that face from our junior final. Mm. Minsyok Park MVP.
Number 12, Cole Gillespie has been subbed on.
Younger brother of Tyron. Oh,
miscommunication there.
There was. Should the six have taken it? Who's six back there? Is that Bailey? Number eight, Bailey. It's pretty tricky when it goes in between one and six, as we know. Sam is his older brother. There we go.
There it is, the name. Yep. Rachel Gunn. Is that Rachel? Hi, Rachel. All the way in the US watching her brother. Unfortunately, Ryan can't play because he injured his leg.
He warmed up. Did he warm up?
Yeah, he warmed up.
Yeah. He hasn't been playing. Oh,
big block there by Sam Anderson.
Sam Anderson. Big block. He's always a winner with a block. Shutting down someone's big attack is always a good feeling. I wouldn't really know because I'm only like 5'2" and can jump about 10 centimetres off the ground, but try my best.
Shout out to the 98 Aurere College Senior Boys team. Yeah, that was 20 years ago. Yes, we were in the same final.
Long
corner. Hi, Tommy.
Long corner and net touch there. Cole, year 11, GOAT Gillespie. Who's the favourite Gillespie people out there? Let us know. Hit us up. Is it Tyron or is it Cole? We'll have votes in and we'll get it by the end of the game. Oh! How did we slip there? He looks okay. That was a good set though. He held him. Yep. That was one-on-one block there. Need to get a wee towel.
Western Heights were the Bay of Plenty champs this year, number one seed. Rangitoto finished second at the Auckland champs.
Behind Orewa. All right, so we a lot of people suggesting Tyron is a bogan. I'm unsure if he is a bogan or not, although I have heard that he is coming back to play a bit of volleyball at school for a second time through year 13.
Who's that?
Tyron. Big bang right now.
Oh, okay.
Oh, touches on. Good touch there by Kobe. Shout out to Sam Dodds and Mitch. Hey, Sam Dodds and Mitch. No, they're on the team. Is Mitch on the court? He is up the front. Big here, Mitch up the front there.
Oh, unlucky there. Lucky mid touch. Good up by the libero. Number 9, Josh Patterson. Bit too eager on the block. Touching the net on the way down. Anderson again just wiping off the side of the block there.
We've been point for point through this game. It's 11-10 at the moment. To Rangitoto just ahead, but it's anybody's game. Number 11 coming on, Travis, for number 2, Josh.
Just talking to the coaches and the managers of Rangitoto before, they have exceeded the expectations this year, so the boys might be feeling a little bit relaxed, playing, coming into this final, got nothing to lose.
What were they aiming for? What, quarters?
Quarters, maybe a top 4 finish.
Yeah. Well, they've done awesome.
Yeah. Whereas maybe the expectation of Heights being in another final.
How many finals have they made?
Oh, probably countless. So many.
Most of these boys must have been in a final before, I'm sure. Oh, big chase from Tyron there. Shout out to Kairatea Butterfield. Shout out to OG Mudbone Bailey Gordon. He's doing well out there. Heading open at the moment. Shout out to Rob. Can see him in the crowd. Let's go, Josh, number four. Number four for Western Heights High School, Josh Tiplady.
Miscommunication there between the setter and the middle player. I think the middle player didn't expect the setter to set up the ball.
It's the pretty close to the outside, eh?
Yeah.
Would have been the time to do it, though. No one was expecting it. Sub Robert Biddle on. There's only one Robert. His name's not Biddle. Is this Robert Fiaula? No, we're looking for number 10 for Heights there. Serves to come from number 4, Josh Tiplady. Topor's finest. Ooh, a bit long. Pretty awesome having learnt from YouTube, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah. YouTube can do anything these days. We learnt how to fix our fridge on YouTube, actually, instead of calling in the fridge man.
Sam Anderson again, just being really smart. Hitting the outside block of a three-man block.
The blocks are crucial in the boys, eh? Slow that ball down, like the such a different game to the girls.
Yeah, the girls are more like, you know, a lot of defensive plays, whereas the boys are more, a bit more physical.
Yeah, up at the net a lot more, eh? Big game at the net. Maybe it's the hang time.
Sometimes I get the question whether does the net get any higher at the international level. The height of the net that the boys are playing on now is the height that international teams play at. So these boys are jumping pretty high.
For some of those tall lads, it doesn't look very high, but it's actually very high, the net.
A few service errors here by Western Heights.
Mm-hmm. Little giant Josh Patty. Number 9, Josh Patterson. He's the libero for Rangitoto. Shout out for you.
Can I please get a shout out to Eugene Bogan? Hi, Eugene. Bogan name is familiar with Western Heights volleyball as well.
Shout out to the Middleton Grange girls, team from Christchurch. And shout out to Kaz Hemwaya Apete and the Heights boys from your Kaz Willie Iona.
Hi, Willie. How are you, Willie? Willie Iona, Western Heights legend.
Is he?
In the middle. Used to call him Rubber Band, and Rubber Band just had this really fast swing.
Like whipped it back real quick?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Eugene Bogan, MVP.
Thanks, Ross. Appreciate that.
Rangitoto take a little bit of a break here. They're 4 points ahead. So Western Heights call a timeout. I think this was a bit unexpected, maybe.
What, that Rangitoto are ahead by a few?
Yeah, by a few.
Maybe going in a little bit too confident. Thinking Rangitoto had the hard semi, just made it through. Heights breezed on through, but Rangitoto was putting up a fight. Serve from Josh Hudson. Good up by Josh. Straight down by Jalen. He's pretty tall.
Yep.
What would he be? 6'4"?
6'5" easy.
Tallest on the court, is he?
Yeah. And I think that's what Western Heights might need to use to their advantage, use him a little bit more, because he's a bit of an energy player.
Mm-hmm.
I've seen it during the week when he gets a few good hits, a few good big spikes, he kind of lifts the team up. Shout out to Father Paola Morrison.
Serve from Maddie Ness to come. Score is 18-14. Still got a bit of a lead. It's a good time to have a few points on the board.
Yeah.
combo. And a net touch as well. Well, it was going out anyway. The boys had it. What are we? A quick B dub something around there. Combo there. Trying to pull a blocker.
They're trying to beat the outer block with a bit of speed.
Subs on. We got number 5, James Wong, for number 4, Josh Tiplady. Topor, you are going to have to wait till your man comes back on. Oh, he's 6-6. 6-6, we were wrong. We're close. Okay. He's at least 6-5.
Yep.
So he's 6-6. That's Jalen. Sorry for guessing 6-4. You can have an extra 2 inches. Lanky is.
Jalen Massey is a just a coordinated version of Billy Johnston. Those of you who don't know who Billy Johnston is, Billy Johnston was the captain of Western Heights from last year's team. And is now in, played for Mau Wau last year, Club Nationals, and now lives in Auckland.
Oh, here we go. Kira, Kobe Hewitt's little sister. Shout out to you, Kira. I'm sure your brother appreciates the support you're giving him on the online stream. He's doing well.
Hopefully we could give you a bit of a rundown of the results of all divisions when we get them.
Yep. So hopefully someone who's listening in the office can bring us down all of the results from the divisions. We're looking up we can probably find that during the next break. We'll look for the division results.
Western Heights pegged the score back a bit, gained on 2 points and come back to about 19-17.
For those of you that weren't watching the girls' final, Westlake girls beat Altamonte College 3-0. Fairly convincing, I guess, in the game. Altamonte was in it for a lot of the game. They did very well, but Westlake was too polished. Too polished.
Yeah, they were way too polished. Very good defense. And then when they pick up the defensive ball and then they're able to convert with the hitters that they had, it was just basically unstoppable. And the third and fourth place for girls, I think Rangitoto beat Aorere College 3-2.
Here we go.
In
tight
the
five
setter, yeah.
It's always a tricky one, eh? When you get to the semis, then you're medal versus no medal.
Yeah.
And the fourth is the one that always just seems a little bit tricky to get.
Height stick that through. Back to a 1 point game now. 19-18.
Go Daniel Ching. Speed ball there. And in.
Nice
good
block
there.
The height that Tyrone just got there was pretty high and then
right up, eh?
Yeah, and as you could see he was actually trying to change his arm so that he was pointing towards 6 so that the ball would go back in.
Come on, Heights, it's 19 all now. That's from Brianna. Come on, Heights. We seem to have a lot of Heights supporters on the chat here. Rangitoto, I'm sure, has a huge amount of fans up in Auckland and around the country. Right in front of us is the big crew of the girls supporting the boys. Good touch by Josh there.
There we go again. Unlucky.
So he's just trying to get that inside the block there, isn't he?
Yeah.
Done that a couple of times now. Sam trying to get inside the block, the setter calling that one. Josh Bully from Rangitoto. Shout out to you, Josh Bully. Sam Dodds on outside hitter.
Nice save there from Hamaya. Pass was a bit tight on the net, and as you can see, he was turning his body towards the net and then did a little nice back set. Back
Sam
to turn you all.
Sam Dodds is there now. Caitlin, he's on the outside, so be ready for a big hit. Serve from Tyron. He's got some good hops, that boy, doesn't he?
Yeah.
That's Tyron.
Nice touch.
Come on, Rangi. Put the scoreboard back up. The score is 21-20 to Rangitoto, if that's not currently on that live stream. 21-20 with Rangitoto serving. That's seven. Sam Anderson just getting the serve in there. Big block and a net touch as well. That's 21-all. Tyron and Cole, massive hops. Who has the biggest hops, though, Tyron or Cole?
So the score is 21-all. So if you can't see the score, we're just going to call it out. It's 21-all.
With heights to serve. Big hit from Sam Dodds there. Straight to the gap. That's now 22-21 to Rangitoto. With number 14, Mitchell, to serve. There were some fans of Mitch on there, wasn't there? Time block just, but they had him closed out there nearly. Score is now 22-all with heights. Number four, Josh Tip Lady for the serve. Cole without a doubt. Better than Tyron, eh?
Travis Howard. Travis has stepped up this whole tournament since Rangitoto's main player, Ryan Gunn, has been out since Auckland Champs.
I guess they've done pretty well to get here without using the main hitter. 23-22 to Rangitoto.
Sometimes it could work against a team, sometimes it goes with the team. Ooh. Nice hit there by Bailey again.
Bailey. Straight to the ground, he just saw the gap and went through. That was an awesome hit. Well done to Bailey. Must have been taught by some pretty solid parents as volleyball skills.
Yeah. His dad and uncle, probably the same hops too. His uncle was a left-handed setter, so. Hi, Michael Gordon's kids. Your dad's a legend.
Big block.
Big block.
20. Oh, there was water. 24-23 game set point to Rangitoto. Timeout, Western Heights.
Got 500 people now on the live stream.
500 people.
Crowd's gone a bit quiet. I think not many expected.
I think there's a lot of Heights fans out there, and with Rangitoto ahead by one on set point, that's pretty hard for them to deal with, but they need to get up for it, I think. Mikey Gordon and Kurt Gordon, legends. There we go. Everyone knows on the live stream here. All right, so we've got number 11, Travis Harrod, to serve for the set. Who's the pressure on here, the passes or the server?
Oh, something, I reckon it's the server. If he just goes easy, then...
Then they're just going to get it.
Good pass
there
from Bailey.
Not too bad, it was a very good pass from Bailey.
There we go.
Yeah. All in the pass, eh? Yeah. All in the pass. Get that perfect pass. You've got three options, four options, five options if you can. Not with the libero out there, though. I guess you could set the libero if you wanted to.
Yeah. I've seen a few tricky things that the liberos have done over the years when someone set them.
Well, often they've just got good handling skills so they can find gaps and
There we go.
Big turnaround. We had Rangitoto on a set point, and now we have Heights on set point. 25-24 to Heights. Serving is number 10, Robert Fiaola. Jalen MVP. Well, you never know. He could be. Western Heights High School from Rotorua, 1-0, 26-24.
It's a bit unfortunate, right at the end there you could see Sam slip. He was going for a big hit, but oh well, Western Heights take the lead.
Well, we'll be back soon.
Welcome back, everyone. If you're watching the live stream of the 2018 Secondary Schools, New Zealand Secondary Schools Volleyball Championship Boys Final between Rangitoto and Western Heights High School from Rotorua.
Right, 1-0 to Heights. Heights with the service of the set.
519 viewers now. We're getting up there. Must be doing a good job as a commentator then, for everyone to view in.
And continue viewing in.
Yeah, continue to view in.
You could leave, but you're still here, so thank you for staying. We really appreciate it. Double hits there. So we've got a little bit of information. Tyron went to the Youth Commonwealth for Beach as well. And we also have Ryan and Sam Anderson won the New Zealand Secondary Schools Beach Champs this year. So we've got a couple of beach players out there doing their thing on the indoor court.
Those of you who see a familiar face, the Rangitoto coach, Johan Tima. Johan Tima played for Rangitoto as a student a few years ago. Hala. Got a scholarship to the University of Hawaii.
This one?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So Johan played for the University of Hawaii and then came back. Played for Harbour Raiders last year when they won the national title, club volleyball.
And then coming back and imparting his knowledge on the boys. Mm. That's always the way with coaching, it's got to be a pay it forward.
Yeah, definitely.
I always find you can never give your coach what they give you, but you can give it on. Shout out to my my coach, Adam Allegiers. Not that you're probably listening, Adam, but but thank you for the years you put into us, we really appreciate it. That's Katikati College.
Nice.
Back through 2003 to 2008, Adam Allegiers was the coach.
Oh, Adam, how was he?
Doing good. He's living in Tauranga. got two little kids, May and Alex. If anyone wants to know, it's the Alleguises. Good turn. Ooh.
Unlucky there.
That was very unlucky.
Yeah.
Himaya, good save good, at the net. Good skills, though. Yeah. Good skills.
I think Himaya comes from a volleyball family. Apete, Dave Apete might be his father if anyone can help out. Well, a big shout out to my coach. Well, he's here somewhere. He's my father.
Your father was your coach?
Yeah.
That's cool.
And he's still going. 20 years strong. Still at the same school. There we go. Dave Apete is the GOAT.
Hey Zeke, from Brian, shout out to Zeke, wherever you are in this world. Timeout already, we have 5-1 and Rangitoto is calling a timeout.
It'll be good to see how they come out after losing that first set. It was pretty tight all the way through and they might be feeling a little bit down just after losing, you know, that tight set when they had the lead and match point.
In the match point, yeah. Oh, set point.
Set point.
It's always tricky to come back from that, eh?
Yeah.
When you think you have it in the bag. First set's always nice to have under the belt.
Yeah. Thank you, Kuratea. So Maya is Dave Apete's son.
The crowd's gone pretty quiet. I think maybe they just need some exciting things to happen. It's been a... We haven't had really, really exciting points just yet, maybe. Get the crowd back into it. We need a Mexican wave, I think. Well, that's always a win for the coach, calling the timeout and getting the miss.
Definitely.
Coach reckons it's their point. Shout out to number 11.
Which number 11?
Jalen or Travis? Ethan, help us out. Jalen or Travis? Well, shout out to both of them. Jalen from Heights and Travis from Rangitoto. Shout out to you both, unless Ethan Mackey specifies.
Got a few, couple of information about the Heights boys coming through too. So Dave Apete and his son Maya are related to Wooly Yona.
There we go. So that was a big shout out to Jalen Massey. Wee knuckle there from him. Oh, missed it from Josh there.
As you can see, the Rangitoto libero or Sam just put the setter underneath a little bit of pressure, having to take the first ball and then Tyron having to set it. Josh wasn't ready. Do you think Himaya Nan's watching with us at Mill Street?
Put Liam on. Liam Chand will be on eventually.
Nice touch there.
Straight out.
Rangitoto wasn't able to convert the easy ball that they got. Good defensive play by Himaya.
Dave Apete named best hands by Hugh McCutcheon. That's legend of volleyball.
Yep.
Oh, is that going to go in? Very close. Jalen is 6'8". There we go. So Jalen has grown from 6'4 to 6'5 to 6'6 to 6'8 in this time. Whether he's grown in the game, but if Jalen's dad is here, then he must be 6'8". So we'll trust Jalen's dad on that one. So he must be the tallest on the court, 6'8", with a reach of, how much more reach would he get there? Oh. With a jump even, he's looking
probably pretty high.
Very like high.
300 and something centimeters. Very coordinated for a very tall kid.
Yeah, he is. It's often the way they grow upward and don't quite coordinate the limbs just yet. Shout out to number 10 and 14 from Rangi. That is Sam Dodds and Mitchell Coulthurst. Shout out to those boys. Doing well out there on the court. Serve from Josh Hudson to come.
Nice hit there by Tyron. Unlucky play by number 2. Joshua Hudson just threw out one hand there.
Wyatt is a very good setter, isn't he?
Yeah.
He's a very good setter.
Well, if his dad was a setter, then you know, it's easy to transfer those skills over to his son. And
it'd almost be rude for him not to be a good setter.
Yeah.
Be disowned by the father. Cole Gillespie for the serve and the tip back to his space.
Sometimes it's not always about how hard you can hit the ball. If you can see the space, you can tip the ball into that area.
A good one who does that is actually Phoenix from Triton High School. Often sees the space and sets it straight to it.
Yep.
Although her mum suggests that she shouldn't be doing that.
Set his dump.
Straight through. Matt Bell there, seeing the space and straight through two blockers. Shout out to Melissa and Kurt Gordon in the crowd. Hi, Melissa and Kurt, if you're listening to the live commentary within the live actual arena.
Yeah, they're here to watch their son play in the national final. I think Melissa also played in the national final for Oates. So we've had a day of family.
We have. Currently 10-7 to Heights. Maya serving. I think that's often the way, isn't it, that people follow on from their parents and their siblings. And
yeah.
Good work by Josh there. They've got a free ball. How are they going to convert it?
Nice set.
Straight to the ground. Yeah. Very good set.
As you can, those of us who are volleyball purists, Heights are passing the ball quite high on the net, which makes Hamaya jump set and it just speeds up the attack.
Mm.
Let's go back to make a 5-point lead now.
12-7. Hard to come back from. One set down, 5 points down. Early days in the set, but they are going to have to work hard to bring this one back.
And it's not wouldn't be the first time in the tournament that they would have had done that. Last night they came back from 9-3 down in the fifth set against.
So they can do it.
Yeah, so they're capable of doing it.
Who got third in the boys' division? Orewa?
Orewa.
Yep.
Orewa beat Trident 3-0. And it's the first time Orewa's won the third and fourth playoff game. So they've been in the semi-final a few times and talking to one of their coaches, every time they've been in the third and fourth playoff, they've lost.
Orewa has?
Yeah.
Yeah. So they got it.
They've got it this time. So.
Such a hard one. You lose the semi, then everyone's like, what does it matter anymore? But it's still for a medal, so still quality. Let's go Heights, let's go clap clap.
Dave Arpete won two titles for Heights back in the 1980s.
So they almost pulled it back there. They had it down to a 3 points and now it's back to 4 points for Heights.
Yeah.
Tyron to serve. And Justine is stoked about Tyron serving. Shout out to Heights all day. Heights volleyball all day. There are so many Heights people on here. Shout out to all those people in Rotorua and around the place going for Heights. Also, we'll shout out to Rangitoto as well. They don't have as many in the crowd, so we'll shout out to all those that are going for Rangitoto.
I think Haitu will be going for their 11th title this year as well.
11th title, same as Otomotai.
Yeah.
Tyron MVP. That's what people are suggesting. There's been a lot of MVP suggestions. Yeah. We'll let you know when that happens after the game.
This year they're doing the tournament team a little bit different.
Just picking the seven players, eh? Not positions, is it?
Yeah, they're picking the seven best players of the tournament through position. So we're going to have best setter, best...
Same as for club, eh?
Yep, similar to what they do in the club volleyball.
So setter, passer...
Passer hitter, opposite and middles, and then libero. Got over the top hit there by Josh. Keeps that 3-point lead that Western Heights have got.
Adam Harris, we'll shout you out because you have been supporting Rangi this whole time. One of the only ones on the chat. So, and we've also got Caitlin as well. Rangi up the toto. I don't know if that's your call, but Rangi up the toto to you guys. Liam Chan for MVP. He has to get on the court. He will soon. They might get him on there.
So it's 14-12 here in the final. Mid touch by Rangitoto, so it pushes the lead out to 15. The game is kind of in a little bit of a lull, you know. I think Western Heights are just going through their motion and...
Yeah. The crowd's pretty, the crowd's just kind of seeing this lull as well, aren't they?
Yeah.
Western Heights seems in control, only by a few points, but...
There we go.
Big height.
Shout out to Kyra Hewitt.
Or Kira?
Or Kira.
We'll go with Kira. Did we get it right, Kira? Or Kyra? Oh, which one is it?
Probably Kira.
Kira. Number 11, Travis there.
You can kind of see that he wasn't, he was kind of underneath the ball, and the ball was always going to go out after he touched it.
Just contacted it wrong.
Yeah.
Mitch 14, MVP. Mitch Coulthurst. Is there an MVP? MVP on top of the, there is an MVP. Overall MVP as well as the positions. So you've got the positions, middle, libero, passer hitter, setter, opposite, and then is it just MVP? Is there six?
No, there's seven.
What's the seventh?
Libero.
Yes, there is an MVP on top though, like an overall MVP. So, thanks, Dan. Yeah, we hope so. Daniel Willis, hope they can pull through. They have done very well here, especially with potentially one of their star players, Ryan Gunn, being out with his injury. So they've done very, very well to get to the final. So that just shows the depth of the team, that they can still continue to go through with potentially one of their stars not being able to perform the whole time.
And your total pick a point back there. Scores now 17-13 to Western Heights.
Yes, Kobe, no sleeves. Maybe Kobe likes rolling up his sleeves. Show off his guns, I'm not really sure. Ooh. Big block there. That was big blocks from number 10, Sam Dodds. Oh no, it wasn't Sam Dodds. That was 13.
Matthew Bell.
Who blocked that? It was Matthew Bell, wasn't it?
And Polder sees that they pegged the score back, so he calls a timeout. 17-13 to Western Heights in the second set.
Yeah, Yeah, Matthew, it was a big block, wasn't it? Straight down. I actually didn't notice Kobe no sleeves, but that's very correct.
There we go, straight over timeout in.
So there we go, Jalen for MVP. That's a comment that's coming through quite a lot, and that was just an incredible shot by him. So well done. Thanks, Leilani. We do need some extras on Farangi. It's just because everyone's talking about heights. We'll talk about Arangi some more. Down by five, but they've still got the spirits there. Got some encouraging chats, claps there from Josh Patterson. Trying to pump the boys up.
Shot Maya from your favourite cousin, Faamauni, Yona, brother of Wooly.
So we're down to 19-15, a four-point gap, and we've got subs coming on. Number two, Josh Hudson, for Rangitoto's number 11, Travis Harrod. Playing backcourt for him. Has it been... Yeah, subbing around through the backcourt there.
Western Heights are just giving Rangitoto, you know, a bit of a chance by serving the ball out twice.
Ooh. And another serve out there.
Serve out.
5 points, 20-15, one set down. That's a big mental game there.
Yeah.
We've got subs on number 10, Robert Fiola, coming on for Jalen Massey. A little bit of miscommunication on the pass there. Tips out. We've got 21-15 to Heights now. So Gary is apparently Mitch's biggest fan. So shout out to you, Gary. Number 14, Mitch out there. Good serve. 22-15. Maybe the crowd's going to come back in it on the third set. I'm Mitch's biggest fan, Gary, Daniel Willis. Well, you guys can battle it out yourselves to be Mitch's biggest fan. There's number 14 for Rangitoto, Mitch Coulthurst. Tyron is a drenched rat, I hear. He's not that bad. He's working hard. He's working very hard.
Certainly by Josh.
Got quite a few people hassling Tyron on the live stream here. That's quite funny. And we are now down to set point.
I think Western Heights have changed their service plan for the last part of the set, where instead of going for a jump serving, they're changing to a float serving. Maybe that's a direction from Polder.
Well done. That is now set to Heights, 25-16. 2-0 to Western Heights High School. They took that one quite almost evenly. In control the whole time. We'll be back with you in a short moment or two. Stick around.
So welcome back if you're watching this live stream of the 2018 New Zealand Secondary Schools Volleyball Boys Final between Rangitoto College and Western Heights High School.
We have so far Western Heights has been in control of this game, 2-0, but Rangi has got a lot in them and I'm sure they'll bring it back.
Yeah, if those of us at the stadium, and you probably wouldn't have seen this, but during the timeout or the change between sets, the manager of Rangitoto had a few hard words to his boys.
Oh, did he? Yeah. I didn't actually notice that.
Could see him go a bit red.
I guess you can see what the boys can do and maybe they're not doing what they could do. It's always hard as a coach. You train them in a certain way and expect them to do certain things, and when they're not performing, it's a little bit tricky. I guess I'll give a big shout out to Tracy Braddock. She is actually one of the greatest coaches I've ever had. She's really incredible. She's got such a kind heart. And Tracy Braddock, for those of you that ever experienced her in volleyball, we're very blessed to be a part of her world. So Tracy Braddock, shout out to you. And for that, she owes me $15. So, big hit. Is that number 8, Bailey Gordon? It was?
Yep.
Yeah, it was.
Bailey Gordon. Very nice, clean hit over the ball. Sometimes it's a bit different when you're like with the height of the Heights boys. A lot of them are quite tall, and then you got Bailey, who's a bit shorter than most of the boys. Just different angles the balls are being hit at.
And different timings,
yeah,
too,
yeah,
eh?
Yeah, different timing. So there you could see Matthew Bell just delay a little bit more.
Subs on early in the piece. Front back, we've got Mitch coming off. We've got a few Mitch fans out there, so Mitch is just having a break for Tim Kwan, who always comes on to serve. We've got two each and two sets at 2-0 for Western Heights.
Shout out to the commentators. Oh, thank you very much, Brian Caulfield.
I need to refresh that. We've got quite a lot of people watching, which is pretty awesome, supporting the boys. Thanks for tuning in. No matter if you're here or on the live stream, the boys appreciate your support. So thank you all that are taking the time to support the boys out here today. Rangitoto fans and the Western Heights fans.
Shout out to my dad, Paula Morrison from Tian Flavel. Interesting rotation there that Rangitoto had done. They probably given Sam a bit of a rest with the backcourt. Now they've subbed him on in the front.
Josh coming in for the serve. Ooh. To the left. He hooked it around to the left that time.
Scores 4-3 to Western Heights to the third set. And shout out goes to De La Salle, who are doing the lines in this final. They finished fifth. Fifth in Division 1 for De La Salle boys. De La Salle won a title in 2008, the first time Nationals was in Palmerston North, so 10 years ago.
Wow.
Yeah.
So they've got the talents here.
Yeah. One of the boys who's doing the lines is a son of a rugby legend. So shout out to Wallace Satiti.
Couple of errors there from Josh. He had the miss serve and the serve into the net.
So it's now 5-4 to Rangitoto.
And a wee word to the captain of Rangitoto. I didn't catch what happened just there. That's Matthew Bell.
And if you know Mary Kerekere, for those of us volleyballers, She's a very strong, firm woman.
She's very strong.
Yeah.
Also extremely kind.
Yes.
She is. But when she needs to tell you to do something, you listen.
Good hustle there by Rangitoto, but the two players just clashed to try and get the ball over. The score is now 5-all.
Big serve. He changed it up. He looked like he was going for a topspin, and then he looked like he changed it, and then it just went out the back. Unlucky from Bailey there.
Rangitoto pushed the set out, the score up to 6-5.
I guess I'd actually quite like to see Rangitoto take this one, make it a bit more of a fight.
Yeah, 6-all. Service error there by Sam.
That's been three service errors in the
last
little bit. It's always the thing as a coach, service errors are the ones you get a little bit gutted about.
Yeah, those of us who know what a coach killer is, that's one of them.
Got Cole Gillespie coming in for the serve. Let's see if he can get it in. First in the last four. He does. Hey. He gets an ace. Cole Gillespie. The best of the Gillespies I've heard.
Nice serve from a young man.
He looks quite young, isn't he? What is he, year 10?
Someone said he might have been year 11.
Year 11.
Comes in to serve an ace.
Why not?
In a national final.
Good touch.
Nice touch.
Well done, Bailey. Gets the control. They've got to bring it back now.
See if Rangi can convert here.
They can. Perfect. Tracy, I said 15, but you can give me 50 if you would like.
Shout out to the commentators and all the volleyball people who made this nationals come true for the boys. Thank you, Whamaoni Iona.
Right to the floor. Good shot there by number 11, Travis Harrod from Rangitoto, finding the ground.
Clark Dirt's what? These serves. I'm not going to say that last word, but you got to remember this is a national final, so there's a lot of pressure going on the boys. So good three-man block there from Western Heights.
So it's 8-all at the moment. Heights has crawled their way back into it. They're a couple of points behind. They've been 1 or 2 points behind throughout the set, but they have definitely brought it back. Oh, unlucky. Touches on the block by Tyre in the air. It just popped off to the left. Two-point lead now. Sam Dodds to serve. A few Sam Dodds fans out there, I've heard. So shout out to the Sam Dodds fans.
Now we can see the Rangi crowd get into the game.
That's one of the few wee crowd calls that they've given.
You see Travis trying to go for a shot there just across the court and just goes out.
Nearly found the floor though. And the flags go up. That was actually something I wanted to do with my team, was create some flags. I was going to use some old PE shirts and have some flags. It would have looked extremely hoary, but I think it would have been really cool. So that's what I'll do next year. Create some flags, some line judge flags.
Yeah. Nice. Oh, nice touch. Oh, nice touch.
Awesome touch by Kobe there, getting it up. Inside the blocks. Well done.
Rangitoto aren't giving up.
No, they're not. They've used it a couple of times, the short outside set to get inside the blocks. And that one, it worked clean to the ground. So they're up by 2 points now. Nice chase by Bailey. Maya brings it back in, reset.
Nice. So Rangi have kind of just created their own opportunities at the moment. Western Heights call a timeout. As you can see, like, the Heights blockers are quite tall, so Rangitoto need to convert every time they get a free ball chance.
Yeah, they do. They do.
And I think they've tried to run their inside ball quite a lot, which is good because it just splits the blockers and gives them two lines.
That's a couple of times that Matthew Bell has done that dump, like finding the floor very cleanly as well. I guess he's not doing it all the time, so they're not on him, and then he does it and he gets it clean. So it's a great move he's doing there.
So the score's now 12-9 to Rangitoto in the third set.
Serve out there. Having a wee difficulty streaming the live chat feed on our phones at the moment, and Hollis's phone is about to die. He's on 1%, trying to keep up with the with everything that's going on in the chat. So sorry if we haven't done any shout outs in a little bit. Here we are, we're in. 535 viewers, here we go. That took a long period of time. Wasn't ready for the hit, and oh, nice. The crowd is back in the game. Massive hit by Jalen Massey there. Number 13, Matthew Bell, coming in with the setter. Good shot from him.
So, sorry guys.
All right, Josh Ford isn't really impressed with the chat. Josh, just sign out if you don't want to listen, mate, or turn down the volume, that's okay. Oh, no. Had a collision on the front, and Josh falls under the net. Slides his feet out.
So our score is 14-11 now in the third set.
Awesome up there by Sam Dodds.
Some nice defensive plays. We played by both sides here during this third set. It's bringing the crowd into the game.
Yeah, that was the biggest cheer of the crowd just before. We haven't heard the crowd getting up too much. Oh, that is, I think, actually the third serve in a row that Josh has missed. So hopefully he can bring back that confidence, because they need to get all those servers getting them in. Awesome up there, number 9, Josh Patterson. number 10, Sam Dodds.
Oh, good up from the Libero there, just adding
very
it.
Good up.
Yeah, then Rangi just transitioned that into attack, pushing the score out to 16-12 now.
Nice. I guess when you've got limbs as long as him, you can do that, can't you? Get on the chases at Bailey. Big swing by Sam Anderson, blocks, send it right to the back of the court.
And as you can, like, if you're watching this game closely, you can slowly start to see that the Rangitoto held Jalen in the middle quite a few times, so they're getting a little bit of a split on the outside. And it's, they created these chances by serving like that and getting free ball chances.
Confidence is growing with these boys now, isn't
yeah.
it? The crowd is louder for Rangitoto now. They're up by 5 and there's timeout to Western Heights, so
18-13 in the third.
For those of you that didn't watch the girls, it was 3-0 to Westlake Girls High School against Otamotai College. And currently the game score is 2-0 to Western Heights High School with Rangitoto in the lead, 18-13. They seem to have picked it up a little bit, Rangitoto has. From Kira, let's go Western Heights High School, get it up there boys.
Come on, Toto.
Hit down the line there by Tyron.
Another sub change here. Bringing on Robert Fiola. Coming and serve.
Second time he's entered the court. Is it the second time? Came through last set as well.
And Travis has come up big the set for Rangitoto. Killing a few balls. Push the score back out to 19-14. First passing error.
Yeah, Kobe hasn't made many passing errors, has he? Just didn't get quite behind that, so he's been doing very well so far. So shout out to the Kobe fans out there, but didn't quite catch that one.
Score now is 20-14 in the third set. Rangitoto lead.
I wonder if we'll see another semi like we did.
Yeah.
Next semi, the 3-2, Rangitoto coming back for the win. Who knows?
Early in the week, these boys, Western Heights, played Rangitoto in pool play, and Western Heights got up on that occasion, 3-1. So it's, game is not over just yet.
There we go. Travis is getting pumped. He's had a couple of kills in the last few points. Been much more cheering from the Rangi fans in this last set.
Mm-hmm. up.
Nice up by Josh there.
Unfortunate. Charles might have been a bit too eager there, hitting the ball out.
Going for the long shot again. Good cover. Yeah. 22-16 we're up to. And we have some sweat on the floor needing a bit of a wipe with the towel. That's actually how, was it Sam who slipped over on a bit of the floor? We were going for the hit and he slipped over.
Mm. Western Heights make a sub there. Bringing on number 5, James Wong, for Josh at the opposite position.
Delay pipe hit from there from Tyron. And we've got sub. Jalen's coming back on for the front. Drazel to serve. Who's lime drink, Sage? Lime drink.
Must be someone's nickname.
Yeah, must be. There's a few lime drink mentions actually. Who's that?
Good
serve. Is that his first entry to the court?
No, he's the starting middle player.
He was starting on the other. Oh, it was only Jalen that went off then for Robert.
And Rangitoto call a timeout. Good call.
I think so. 22 isn't quite enough to be that comfortable, is it?
Yeah.
Lime drink is Liam Chand.
Number 7.
So there's some, obviously a lot of Liam Chan fans out there. We've seen Lime Drink lots and we haven't actually mentioned him. So big shout out to Liam Chan and all of his fans. Liam is the GOAT. He's the best bench warmer in New Zealand. Well, if he's going to do his job well, then he's probably going to have to stay on the bench, isn't he, if he's the best one. But shout out to Lime Drink.
Another good ace.
That's his second ace, isn't it, by Drazel?
Drazel Edwards serves the second ace.
Probably the right time to do it, really. Yep. They're down in this third set, but they can easily come back at just point by point.
And now the passers start to put play mind games in their head. Another good serve there.
Safety ball over. Are they going to convert this one? Straight down. Oh, no.
And all that's been created by is the service pressure that Drazel has put on. The two aces and then that serve down the line, putting Travis off in the pass. Rangitoto called their second timeout, so they've used both their timeouts now.
Within this one server, really, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So the score is now 22-20 to Rangitoto. Western Heights have pulled back a few points through the serving of Drazel Edwards.
Liam won't be on the court. He just broke his ankle before Nationals. So those fans for Liam, apparently he won't go on the court. Although he's in his playing gear, so he might get on the court.
And same with Ryan Gunn, main player from Rangitoto, who hasn't played here at Nationals. He did his ankle in the Auckland Champs final. He's in his playing gear.
Just in case, eh?
Just in case. So both
a little
boys,
bit hopeful, I reckon.
Yep.
Drazel has done some fantastic serving in this like pressure time. Nice. And Jalen gets up to kill this one here.
So now it becomes a mental game between the Rangitoto passes and Drazel is serving.
Well, what's that? How? What were they on? 17?
17.
Yeah, so he's in
22-21.
Two aces, two pressure serves. Oh, and he's out. They will be thankful of that. 23-21 to Rangitoto. The crowds are right next to the boys at the moment, down the scene, so very exciting seeing them just up close.
There we go again. Nice pass. Just a bit off the net. High set into the middle. And Jalen kills it. It's very hard to block where you've got a middle player who's 6'8". Got a very good jump.
Yeah.
Very high reach. Nice up there by Bailey.
And we'll do a shout out to Bailey here, not only a good volleyballer, but a good boyfriend and brother-in-law. So those fans of Bailey out there.
Just crucial ball.
Very crucial point there.
Yeah. Free ball chances and boys might be a bit nervous about receiving the ball. Rangitoto hasn't been able to convert. Wilson Hart have fought back at this set. It's now 23-all.
Serving from James Wong out there.
Ooh.
Didn't hear the whistle, served a bit early. So it's 23-all.
Bit of an anti-climax.
It was an anti-climax.
Yeah.
A shout out to my main man, JC from Heights. The Western Heights boys are now on match point. So James serving.
They've come back from 22-17 down to now lead by 24-23.
Awesome comeback. Drazel serving most of that, so with James serving this final point. Oh no! 24-all.
Now that's got the crowd excited.
The crowd is very excited. Rangi's choking. I don't think they're choking. I think they've just had a good server against them. Potentially a mental game there, though.
Good serve.
Good serve. Oh, no. Ball into the net. So we've just gone match point to set point within 2 points.
Experience call there by Polder. Very experienced. After a mistake and you don't have any more timeouts left, call a sub.
This is a good time, isn't it?
Yeah.
Safe serve.
Got a convert here.
Set to Rangitoto. 2-1, crowd is up. Big turn of events here. We've got some tired looking boys, some excited looking boys. The crowd is going crazy.
It's picked up now. 26-24 on the third set. Things might have been different if the Rangitoto had won their first set and were in a close situation just like this.
All right, we will be back very soon. 2-1 to Heights, Western Heights High School against Rangitoto in the 2018 Boys Volleyball Final. Right, welcome back to the boys' final 2018. Just had Rangitoto take the third set to make the score 2-1. Shout out to Alex Gardner, listening on here. Best middle I know. Coolest middle I know. From Josh there from Taupō. Taupō's finest in the Western Heights team.
Looks like a bit of feeling going into the game now, which is pretty cool to see.
Taupō is back. He is. Has made a couple of errors, Josh has, but he's back in there with a hit, so hopefully fourth set he's on fire. Chased by Travis there. Probably could have got it with his hands, actually.
Yeah, yeah.
I think that was maybe a little bit lazy. Ran and then kicked it.
HVB need to get Tyron back in the game. Yeah, I think that's what Western Heights need to do, like give him a bit more ball. He's been their go-to player the whole week.
Yeah.
Bit of a deliberating going on right now.
Must had some subbing problem or maybe the coach stepped past the 3 meter line, which is what I did today actually. Stepped past the 3 meter line, got a bit of a warning. Stay in my own zone.
Someone's left the bench.
Some confusion here. We actually don't know what's going on at the moment.
If we find out, we will let you know.
Second ref, Tim, is going over to talk to first ref, Mary. Unsure of what's going on.
Concussion? No. Wrong rotation? Maybe.
First sub for the set, though, so you shouldn't think there's any subbing issues.
Yeah.
Oh, has he just gone out?
Yeah.
All right, so we've just got a wee bit of info. Number seven, just been
Sam
subbed
Anderson.
Off. Sam Anderson has just gone to vomit in the toilets. So he potentially has the gastro. He wasn't looking that flash. We've just had information from some of the fans in the crowd. So is that he's got gastro? Is that what you're thinking? He's got gastro. Yep. All right. Poor guy. So we got Sam Anderson. Who's not doing very well at all, and he's just subbed off to have some love with the toilet.
Poor kid.
Apparently, he's spewed up on the court as well throughout the week, so he isn't doing well. So he's been doing incredibly well, actually, to
play and
to play already. Like, what? How long's it been going for? An hour and a bit. Hour 15, nearly. When he's been feeling absolutely terrible. Looks like the Walking Dead, one of the fans is suggesting.
Heights not taking any sympathy, though.
No, they're not. I wonder if he's allowed to sub back on. I wonder if that was the confusion with the refs, whether he's allowed to go back on if he's been vomiting within the game. Yeah, bring back Sam, eh? We'll let you know when he enters the stadium again, but currently he's out at the bathroom area.
Nice little set there by Hamaya, trying to use the middle.
Bring back Dez in the red jandals.
Those red jandals haven't been seen in a while.
Shout out to Dez and Mary, legends. Oh, absolutely right. Power couple in volleyball, those two are. The weak combo, first and second ref would be the dream, Dez and Mary. So Sam's entering the stadium again. He's not looking incredibly flash though. His face is looking a little bit pale, or is that just his regular face?
Oh.
He looks a bit pale,
yeah,
doesn't he?
Yeah, he does.
Yeah.
Even though he's already
so
pale.
So that's, Sam Anderson, number 7 for Rangitoto. He's not looking flash. He's just walked back into the stadium. That's that bug's taken out a few teams, actually. It's the reason they had to cancel the social in the end. Isaiah, proud of your brother. That's awesome. He's been doing very well, actually, Isaiah. Very, very well out on the court. He's won a huge amount of points. And Mitch will be out there soon, I'm sure.
Service error by Tim Kwong. And he comes off being liberated off in the backcourt. Score is 7-2 to Western Heights. Drezel puts on another pressure on the serve.
There we go. Alright, Josh back in it. Maybe it's had a bit of a lull, but he's definitely back in there, so well done, Josh. All those people watching in Taupo, shout out to you. Shout out to Jim Gemmel.
There we go, Drezel again with
the
serve.
Yeah, Drezel's just getting them on that serve, isn't he?
Yeah.
I guess it must just be dropping quite quick. They can't quite read it. There we go. And again. Drezel's extended the lead to 10-2. I think that sub out of Sam has really put a potentially like a little bit of a dampener on the team on the other side.
Yep.
Obviously look to Sam. They've been using him quite a bit on the open.
Those of you watching, if they showed the Heights timeout circle there. Polder giving stern words to his boys. Don't let them back into the game.
Good idea to time out on Drezel because he's got them with a few now.
Yeah.
Bring back Chand. Liam will be on one day. There
good,
we go.
Good time out by you,
very good time out.
Score now is 10-3 to Western Heights in the fourth set.
Oz Quasi, number 7 for Heights. Oz Quasi. Put on Chand. Everyone is Liam Chan's fan.
Okay. Is that lime drink?
I feel like, yes, lime drink. I feel like I want to be Liam Chan's fan now. So I am going to fight those that want to be his number one fan. I'm in. Gary.
Yeah. Set was a bit tight there for Matthew Bell. Good block pressure for Bailey.
Yeah,
swing through the middle gear. Matthew Ness.
Matt Ness finding the space. They need to get a few serves in a row, don't the Rangi boys do?
Scored.
Down at 11-5.
Nice. There we go. And straight away, Polder calls out a timeout for Western Heights.
Forcing the overpass with that serve.
The score now is 11-6 to Western Heights and full set.
I think it's good because the Rangitoto boys know that they can take the sets. It's just whether they can keep fighting until the end with that 3-1 against them in pool play.
Yeah.
So far we're sitting at 2-1.
And they've come back from this far before too, so it's not out of them. It's just whether they could believe it, that they could do it.
Yeah.
And with Sam Anderson out now, looks like he won't be back in the game.
Dodds there. And actually on that team they've got two Sams and two Matthews.
So they pegged the score back a bit. It's now 11-7.
Good comeback. Very good comeback. Serving is Josh Hudson.
Yeah.
Oh, and two Joshes. Mm. Two Sams, two Matts and two Joshes. Call one of those names and we're sure to get it right. So yeah.
Polder just made an interesting call there. He subbed off Bailey and he's brought on Little Gillespie. Now, Rangitoto have gone on a run.
How many is that in a row? Were that five?
Yep.
So is that three in a row? Four in a row.
Four in a row.
They're on four.
Now you sub Bailey back on again. So just for 1 point. So he's used both those timeouts.
So he's subbing just to...
just to slow the game down. Heights needed that point there. Push the score back out to 12-8. Bailey to serve.
For those wondering about Sam Anderson, he's at the end of the bench and he's not looking flash, so send some well wishes to him because he's not head down in his knees. He's obviously feeling terrible, so make sure you give him a text after the game. Give him a phone call, bring him some chocolates and some a hot water bottle or something when you get home. Awesome pass by Josh Patterson there. Straight to the corner.
Good hit there through the pipe by Bailey. Hitting the side of the court.
Let's go, Rangi. That's from Dan Willis. You've been on there for a while, Dan. Keep supporting them, they need it. 14-9. And Matt Ness is on for the serve.
Graham Lowe for MVP. Change of option there by Hamaya. Instead of calling Jalen into the front of him, he sets a little short D set.
So Robert is back on to serve again for Jalen. He's done that nearly every time?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Every set.
Yeah. And he serves it out. Wasn't that the worst? Coming on to serve and then you serve it out.
I know a few boys, I won't put them out on live stream, but knowing some of them to come on match point and serve the ball out.
Good read there. Number 11, Travis Harrod. All over Bailey's attempted sneaky shot there.
Cover defense was too good.
Josh gets an awesome up.
Everyone just stood there watching
everyone
it.
Everyone just watched it hit the ground. Plenty of height too. Many, like three or four of them could have gone in for that second shot. Travis with the pass and the hit there.
Score 16-12 to Western Heights in the fourth.
And now serving as well, Travis. If he gets this ace, he'll have the triple threat, the pass, then the hit, then the serve. Sending it out the back. It's going to take a lot to come back from this. Travis with the pipe?
Yep. Yeah. Travis on the pipe ball. So Travis will be the go-to guy now since Sam's gone off.
And I don't know that Sam will be coming back on. If you can see his face at the moment, he's not looking flash at all. The double Matthew there, 12 and 13, the Matthew and Matthew combination. Big block. Brings Travis Harrod for MVP. He has been doing well. He has become the go-to at this moment.
Brings the score back 17-14 in the fourth. Good serve. Nice block there. Now, if you just saw that, I think Rangitoto went with a different blocking front. They put number two, Joshua Hudson, into the middle, the short, and try to put Matthew Ness to the outside just to get a matchup with Josh there.
Good serve.
Travis just unlucky there, trying to go for the deep corner, and he just hits it out.
If we were a few metres closer, we could actually give you a shout out for Liam Chand. We can see him. He's about 6 metres from us, but he won't hear us from here. But if we could shout out to him for all of you, we would.
Yeah.
Number two, Josh Hudson up against big four, Josh Tiplady, and gets the block up against them.
Very good timing there.
It was. That's a big point. That would have been 14-20 instead of 19-15. Yeah. So every point at the moment is crucial for Rangitoto.
There we go. Big Jalen in the middle.
Jalen doing what he does best.
Yeah.
Awesome setup by Bailey too. By Maya.
Rangitoto needed that side up before just to get the setter into the backcourt. Give them more options in the front.
Good serve. Nice up by Josh.
Miscommunication there between the two Matthews.
And Josh got a serve in just before, which is good.
Yeah.
Missed a couple, so he's back on fire. I think a couple of good hits gets your head back into it, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Or is it 20?
22-15 to Heights. 3 points away from a national championship.
For the 11th?
11th.
11th national championship. Oh, awesome up by Libero there. Out. Oh, what an up bro from Josh Patterson.
Josh Patterson has played so well in this final. It's a pity that
the hitters
have been just making... I think they're being aggressive, but they're just making a bit more errors than the Heights boys have.
And he gets it up again.
Josh off the serve, though.
Yeah. Oh, no. Okay, we are up to match point. 24-15.
So championship points to Heights. Josh with the serve.
Call a timeout, Rangi. Do they have another timeout? I think 24-15, they might be feeling it. Good pass.
And there we go.
Big block from Jalen Massey. That is winners. Western Heights High School 3-1.
Well done, Heights. Number 11. Congratulations. Also, congratulations to Rangitoto for fighting it out in the four-set final. With all the things they had to go through this week. Well, thanks tuning in.
Thanks for all those people that have been here the whole time. Appreciate it. The boys are going to appreciate it. We've got a haka coming now. We should put the audio on for that. It's been a pleasure. Have an awesome rest of the weekend, everybody.
See ya.
Ladies and gentlemen, if you could please take a seat while we take this opportunity to finish off with our closing ceremony. Thank you.